Swaggy Swan family, thank you so much for tuning in. I'm happy to bring this video to you. This video was requested. You guys wanted an updated video on how I grew my daughter's hair using rice water super fast. This is her when she was a baby, her at about 5 to 6 months old, and I had been using authentic Jamaican black castor oil at that point, in some instances aloe vera, and also the rice water rinse. I'd say to start using that when you feel it's best, but around the mark of 7 to 8 months should be sufficient enough, depending again on your child's hair porosity. Also, as you can see, this is Savannah's hair when it is blown out. I've shown this clip before, but it's a pretty good demonstration of really how thick, full, and healthy her hair is. I'm going to show you how I make my rice water. So first, I use brown rice. It actually doesn't matter if you use white or brown. Just don't use yellow rice would be my recommendation. So this is just regular brown rice from my local grocery store. And I'm going to pour that into the glass jar that you see next to the rice. I do not go and buy mason jars. I just use jars that I no longer have use for, because you guys know I love to be budget friendly. I'm not trying to break the bank just to do hair care routines, and you don't need to either. So definitely just use a glass jar you have around the house. Just clean it out really well and you should be good to go. And definitely try not to use plastic bottles. After putting in about half a cup of rice, you're just gonna add some water from the faucet, which is fine. And this is important if you don't want your rice water to smell horrible, because that's what happens when rice water sits and ferments. You can either add mandarin peels, orange peels, lemon peels, some type of fruit peel that has a skin, add it to it, and then when you open this within 24 hours or at least 8 hours minimum, you shouldn't have a funky smell. If not, you got on your own, because it will smell so bad. Anyway, you're gonna want to use a bottle like this. This is just a really inexpensive spray bottle that I got from Walmart. I like this one because it has the filter cap at the end. This is also really good for my aloe vera sprays that I make, and being a self-made filter in a sense. But anyway, I use this for my rice water rinses also, because it gives me great coverage. So once your rice water has sat for a minimum of 8 hours or more, you can go ahead, pour that into the bottle. And since it has fermented, you have all of the patera and great stuff in the rice water that's going to help your child's hair. It's going to give it the nutrients it needs. I'll go over that a little bit more later on in the video. You've poured that into your spray bottle. Now you're ready to get to action. Now, when it comes to any type of hair washing routine or hair routine in general with my daughter, I always make sure to have a great shampoo. This shampoo is from Urban Hydration. It's called the Jamaican Castor Oil, Avocado Oil, and Aloe Vera Juice Shampoo and Detangler. So that sounds like a lot going on, but for good reason. It has ginger, essential oils, provitamins, argan oil, and it also states specifically it prevents damage, promotes growth, moisturizes, and it strengthens and softens the hair. If you can find a shampoo that indicates these things, it's definitely a plus. Anything, first of all, with Jamaican black castor oil is a plus, and also with aloe vera juice is definitely a plus. So that is the powerful shampoo I'm going to be using for her hair. I really like this stuff. And in my experience, it gets the job done. I pour that in my hands and I work in two sections, mostly with Savannah's hair. I'm trying to move quick, fast, and as pain-free and drama-free as possible when it comes to hair washing. If you need specific tips on how to get through the hair washing process drama-free, tear-free, definitely check out some of my other videos where I go into great detail on some other tips that I use. But as you can see here, she's really not paying attention to me because she's playing with her toys. I'm also not using this as anything else but just a distraction. Okay, so I'm getting by quickly, and by allowing your child to play, or even if you have something that they can do, they have washable crayons that you can use in the bath. That's another great distraction, especially if you have a child that's the same age as Savannah. She's a toddler and she's busy. So I'm working that bottom section and I'm cleansing it really well. As you can see, her shampoo is responding really well in her strands. They're starting to wave up nicely. That's something you want to look for. The hair doesn't feel like it's been stripped, but it feels like it's getting cleaner and cleaner. I'm literally using her teacup set to wash it out because, again, it's about making it light, friendly, and drama-free. Sometimes kids can get overwhelmed if you come out with a big bucket or a cup or anything like that, and it can make them, you know, nervous and razzled. Now I'm going to take that rice water spray and I'm going to spray her hair. I'm starting off with that back section, and that's why I really, really like this spray bottle, because you get a lot of coverage. You're going to want to spray it all around your child's hair, and you'll start to see her hair is responding to the rice water. It's starting to curl up, which is ideal. So let me just show you, when her hair is stretched, it's well down her back, so you can see she does experience shrinkage, but her hair has grown lovely and the rice water has been extremely helpful. Rice water helps with elasticity in your child's hair, so it's going to help to bring those strands out, stretch them, and allow them to grow really, really fast and longer. Another recommendation is, as you can see, I've added a conditioner to Savannah's hair. It's in her entire head, and what I will do is I spray in more of the rice water after the conditioner, and I simply just washed it out with cool water to seal everything. So just showing you again, once she is out and the hair has been washed, definitely want to add some type of hair moisturizer. I'm adding an avocado milk moisturizer by Miel Organics. It's a great go-to. You want to add a cream-based moisturizer, preferably, especially since it is, you know, colder weather currently. You want to do that also because rice water can be very drying. That's a big complaint that a lot of parents or people have who use it on their hair, is sometimes they feel like their hair is getting drier. It could be so. There's lots of protein when you're doing that rice water treatment. You can try to dilute it with more water after you've transferred your rice water into your spray bottle. That can kind of help with the potency of it. Or you can just simply use it as is and add a moisturizer to your child's hair. You can see Savannah's hair is silky smooth. I've added the moisturizer that combined with the rice water rinse. You can see the hair should be springy. Your child's hair should not be dry and brittle after doing your rice water treatments. If that is the case and it doesn't look like what you see here, where it's able to be bouncy, luxurious, and seriously moisturized to sight, then you're definitely going to want to add a moisturizer to the routine. I can't stress that enough, because it is very potent, and again, it has a lot of protein. Also, you're going to want to be familiar with your child's hair porosity. If your child has low porosity, then you're not going to want to do rice water rinse in their hair as frequently, because it will be drying and also can have an adverse effect and break their hair off. My recommendation, try once or twice a month if they have low porosity hair. If your child has high porosity hair, they can handle protein a little better, and you can do the rice water treatment probably more frequently. Just pay attention to the signs and how your child's hair is reacting. If it's not reacting well, that means you have to alter the routine. But if it's done correctly and in moderation based on their hair needs, you are going to see their hair flourish. It's going to become thicker, longer, extremely faster than it would if you weren't using some of these methods, such as the rice water rinse, and you're really going to see the benefits of it. Always be sure to detangle after moisturizing the hair. Again, because you are using a protein-based treatment like rice water, you just want to be extra careful in terms of how you care for the hair afterwards, so you don't experience any kind of breakage. And just to reiterate the key points of this video, rice water is very beneficial for your child's hair, just like it is for adults' hair. When used correctly, you can definitely see results of healthier, longer hair faster. Remember, curly hair and kinkier hair can get very dry and brittle, which is why rice water rinses are excellent. They penetrate the hair shaft, and the vitamins in the rice water from the fermentation process help to condition the hair and put it in a healthy state. My recommendation is, if your child has low porosity hair, do rice water rinses once to twice a month, and for high porosity hair, 3 to 4 times a month. I hope this information was helpful. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe.